what is good, y'all? It's your boy Dylan, aka Dizo, and we're back with yet another video. And as you can see, the background changed and the quality changed. So you guys are making moves around here, so stay tuned for that. But as you can see, we got a package. Now, in today's package is the recently released Air Jordan 1 Women's Exclusive Lucky Green. So without further ado, let's get into the shoe. And there you guys have it, the Women's Exclusive Air Jordan 1 Lucky Greens. Now, I wouldn't call this a Lucky Green, I would call this more of a Kelly Green. My Eagles fans out there, you know what I mean by Kelly Green, that real old school, like vintage style green almost, is what I would more consider this. I mean, either whatever you want to call it is fine, whatever. But overall, like, I like this shoe. I like the feel of it. I like the colorway. It's a good looking shoe. Now, the timeline for this shoe is when it first surfaced with the pictures, I wasn't about it at all. Didn't really like it. I felt like it was an odd combination. As I looked into the shoe and the backstory of it, I began to like it a little bit more, and it kind of grew on me. Still didn't want it. Then I saw some YouTube videos on it where people did some on-foot looks, and it grew on me, and I wanted it for myself. I wanted it in my collection. So after seeing it in hand, I am really glad that I went for it. Now, I did go for it on the sneakers app. Of course, I didn't hit. So I did pay resale for it, but resale isn't too crazy right now, and I'll get into that later on. So going on to the upper of the shoe, all these white panels is a more tumbled leather. It's not overly tumbled. It's not overly premium. It's a good medium tumbled leather. Has a good feel to it. It's not too rough, not too soft. Now, accented is these green panels on the shoe, and that's more of a soft plush leather. It's not tumbled, it's like a more smooth leather, and I like the feel of it. I feel like it's a good contrast on the shoe. There is red accents on the wings logo, the tongue tag, and then that heel tab, whatever you want to call it as well. The red is to represent and pay homage to when Jordan dropped like 60 something points on the Celtics back in the playoffs. So once I read into the backstory of the shoe, I was like, okay, that's kind of fire. I like it a little bit more. Now, if you guys can see on camera, the shoe has a real unfinished or deconstructed look almost, kind of like an off-white, which is cool. The reason I don't like it is because this isn't sewn on. It's like more like a flap, if you guys can see that. And I'll wind up probably lacing these a little bit different so that flap is no longer there. And then there's a flap down here as well. But, you know, it's not a make or break for the shoe. You have your standard nylon tongue. And another really cool aspect of this shoe I'll show you guys right now is look at that right there. The insole of the shoe is actually modeled after an old school basketball court, and I just feel like that's a really fire addition. It's almost like you're stepping on the Celtics court that Jordan stepped on and basically shit on the Celtics. So that's pretty funny there. I don't know if you guys can tell on camera, but the color of the midsole is actually more of a sail color, and the upper is more of like white leather. Now, I wish they just did sail all the way through, because I feel like it would have really made the shoe look a lot better. I can understand why they didn't, though, because then it would really resemble that the pine green ones, which is cool. I get why they didn't do it. And then it leads into a black outsole, so a good contrast. Now, another thing I really liked about this shoe, and another reason why I really wanted it, is it actually reminds me of the Heineken Nike Dunks. And those are a growl for me. I love the way they look. I probably won't ever obtain them because the price of them are ridiculous. So, got the next best thing. Now, coming in the box with the shoes, you do have standard factory black laces that they come laced with. Then you also have, as you can see here, a pair of red laces to match that the accents of red on the shoe. And then you also have a pair of green laces. Whatever you guys like, go for it. I'm going to keep in the black laces because I feel like it gives it the best look. Maybe around Christmas time, I'll use these and I'll do like a red and green lace for like a Christmas outfit or something like that. That'd be kind of cool, but that's pretty much it. But yeah, overall, the shoe's really nice. I'm really glad I picked it up. That's going to do it for the review. There's not much more to say. It's an Air Jordan 1. Oh, wait, I will talk about resale real quick, though. So like I said, I didn't hit on sneakers. Of course, whoever does. But I did pay resale for it. Now, I paid about $250, so about $70 over retail, which isn't bad. And I know it's still sitting between like that $220 to $290 range for all sizes pretty much. So I recommend you guys grab it now because it's going to go up in price over time. People are going to learn to appreciate this shoe. Oh, and I almost forgot. Sorry, actually. The swoosh is patent leather, which doesn't bother me. It does have a little bit of shine to it, but I feel like it gives the shoe a nice look, so I'm cool with that. That's gonna do it for the review. Stay tuned to the end of this video for the on-foot b-roll. That's all I have to say about the shoe. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to leave a like down below. Let me know in the comments, are you guys copping these? Are you guys gonna pass on them? I feel like you should cop them. And let me know what shoes you're excited about in the near future. I know we have the Off-White 5s dropping on the 29th. They did show up on the sneakers app. And then 2 days later, we have the Dark Mocha 1s that are dropping, and I'm excited for those as well. So those are my two shoes that I'm excited for. So let me know what you guys are excited for. But that's going to do it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let's hit 150 subs. We're at 120 right now, about 125. So we're steadily growing. So let's hit that 150 milestone, guys. I appreciate you. And as always, stay hungry. Stay humble, be an inspiration to those around you, and I will catch you guys in the next one.